In this example, we are required to find the equivalent resistance across terminals A and B as shown in figure. Here also each resistance in the given circuit is of value R. Now again, across the terminals A and B, we can see that the circuit is symmetrical with respect to both of the terminals. So for calculation, here again we connect a 100 volt battery, that will be for calculation ease. And say it imparts a potential 0 volt and 100 volt that we are assuming on the two sides. The only thing is, even if you take here 50 and 150, that will work well because the difference of the two terminals of the battery must be 100 volts. Now in this situation, if a current I is flowing through the battery, which is supplied by the battery to the circuit, it will be divided in, here you can see it will be divided in 5 parts. And by symmetry, you can see these currents I1 and I1 will be same. So if these two currents are same, the currents which will be combining here will also be same, I1 and I1. And finally, it will constitute the current I. In these parts, here you can say if these currents are I2 and I2, and this will be I3. Just by observation, I am dividing. Even if I take different currents, it won't disturb the way in solving the problem. So here also, at the time of recombination of current, this will be I3 and this will be I2 and I2. Now in this situation, we can see if here potential is 100, here it is 0. If I take potential at this junction to be x, potential at this junction must also be x. This is because for both of these resistances, equal resistances, same currents are flowing. And if your potential is 0, potential at these two points must be same. Similarly, if the same current I1 is divided here in resistances R and R, potential at these terminals can be taken as 100 minus X and 100 minus X. If we talk about this terminal, for these two resistances, same current, same potential difference, here it is 0, here it is 100. That means potential here it must be 50. And with the same logic, you can see that potential at these terminals will also be 50. And if you wish, we can remove the middle resistances because we know, we have studied in case of balanced Wheatstone bridge that no current flows between terminals of equal potential. So whichever resistance which is connected between same potential points can be easily removed and it won't affect the overall configuration of circuit. But anyway, we are not bothered about it. We can directly calculate the value of total current I by constitution of I1, I1, I2 and I3. And we can directly write the equivalent resistance to be equals to 100 by I. And here this I can be written as 100 divided by, this can be constituted by 2I1 plus 2I2 plus I3. This is the way we are going to get. We just need to calculate the values of I1, I2, I3 and we'll substitute here. All these currents we can easily calculate. I2 and I3 we are already aware about because these potentials are known. For I1 we just need to calculate the value of X. So in solution we can write KCL equation for X gives, this you can write the sum of outgoing currents at these three terminals, as these three branches at the terminal X will be equal to 0. So current going in this direction will be X minus 0 by R, plus current going here will be X minus 50 by R, plus current going in this direction will be X minus of 100 minus X divided by R, this should be equal to 0. On simplifying here, R gets cancelled out, this will be 4X is equals to 150. So again X can be written as here it is 75 by 2 volt. And if you know the value of X, you can easily write down the value of R equivalent. This will be 100 divided by 2I1. Here I1 we can write as X upon R. So this will be 2X by R plus I2 we can write as 50 minus 0 by R. I3 can also be written as 50 minus 0 by R. So these three can be combined and it can be written as 3 times 50 minus 0 by R. And here on substituting values, this will give us 100 divided by 2x. We can write as 75. This will be 75 plus, this will be 3 into 50 is 150. And R we can take in numerator. So this will be 100 upon 225 R. That can be written as RAB in this equation. Finally, we are getting is 4R by 9. That will be the answer to this problem.